Hey you guys, happy Friday. So I woke up with some crazy allergies today. You can see my nose is all red. I've been sneezing and blowing my nose all morning. I'm going crazy. I already took my Zyrtec and everything, and I don't know, it's not working that great. So I want to be doing today's tutorial like this, so sniffly and stuff, so I'm sorry about that. My throat is also itchy, but I think it's because of all the sneezing and I don't know. Anyway, today I want to do a tutorial where I focus on skin, and I want to do the no makeup makeup look, focusing on skin again and spot correcting and concealing. So yes, that's what we're gonna do today. I already moisturized my skin with a few different moisturizers. I primed my face with face primer, eye primer. I just used the ones I've been using the past couple days, Urban Decay eye primer potion and the Smashbox Photo Finish foundation primer. But since I want to focus on skin, I want to make it look dewy. So to do that, I'm going to do a few more steps. These, I'm sure, are products that you probably don't have, and that's okay. Just watch the video and, you know, just have it for reference for later on when you are able to buy products, or if you want to buy the products online, that's totally cool. I'm going to be using the Aqua Glass Coating Cream by the company named Ready. The name of the company is Ready. And I'm also going to use I Do Care Straight Radiate. And this is just like a gold tone type of moisturizer that leaves that gold cast all over your face. And I may spray the Body Prescriptions facial mist, and all those products are just gonna make you have a very dewy and smooth kind of look before you start applying concealers or foundations. So yeah, let's start. So this is what this product looks like, and I'm gonna start by just grabbing some of the product with my brush. This is just a foundation brush, and I'm gonna put it all over my face. So this is sort of like a highlighter, but it's also a very nice moisturizer. So I have on a ton of moisturizers right now, and my skin is still dry. Let's see how this just makes my skin look dewy and highlighted. Love it. The next product I'm gonna apply is the facial mist. I'm running out of this. And now I'm just gonna let it dry before I apply the face Aqua Glass Coating Cream. Still drying, so I'll be back in a couple of minutes. So that took way longer than expected, so I decided to go ahead and do my eyebrows, and I'm still waiting, it's still a little bit wet. But I am gonna go ahead and apply the Aqua Glass. So I'm gonna do the same, clean this, and put some of it on my skin. Thank you. Now, can you see how dewy and wet my skin looks? It's incredible. I'm obsessed with this product, and of course, with everything I put on, it just makes my skin look amazing, like glass. Alright, so I just wanted to show you up closer what the skin looks like. Alright, so I'm going to be using several products for this. First one is this. I am aware that you most likely do not have this, but I'm sure you have concealer and foundation, so grab your foundation. I'm not going to tell you what this is because it's just a mixture that I made of different ones. And then grab either or. I think I'm just going to do the foundation because I know it's easier for you to see. Foundation brush. A sponge I don't recommend because it's gonna soak all the product and we're gonna use very little product. So grab a little bit of foundation and start applying it on different spots where you might have discoloration on your skin. And start blending it. Remember to use only a little bit of foundation, not too much, because it then defeats the purpose of the whole thing, which is a very skin-like look. Minimal makeup or no makeup. See, you can already see a difference in your skin. So I put a little bit too much on the brush, so I just turned it around and started blending with the other side. Probably gonna be red here, and I'm probably gonna blow my nose in a little bit, so it's gonna be gone and I'm gonna have to apply again. But anyways, if you have any little spots, just put a tiny bit of foundation on those spots. Where you have imperfections and cover them and blend them. Again, I wanna keep repeating, use as minimal amount of foundation as possible. If your foundation is too dark, for example, maybe mix it with your concealer. Dilute it a little bit, and that's gonna help. You can also use like a lotion, some kind of like face lotion or skin lotion, and mix it with your foundation, and it'll most likely make it lighter than it is. If your foundation is too light, maybe try adding a concealer that's darker or closer to your skin, or just use concealer. So just try different things out and practice. Alright, I'm not adding any more product, I'm just kind of blending it into my neck, and now I'm going to go into concealer. So, let's see, I'm going to switch to a smaller brush, and I'm going to go maybe into this one. I think I need to use a lighter shade, so I'm gonna mix it with a lighter shade. can't really see what I'm doing. I need glasses. Put a minimal amount of concealer as well. You just want to cover the darkness as much as you can. So you can use your fingers too. And if you only have a full coverage concealer, use as little as possible and spread it out as much as you can. Alright, now we're gonna use a translucent powder, but we're gonna use as little as possible again. Here I have my Ben Nye powder, my huge eye blending brush, and I'm gonna do what I always do, just what I need. So under my eyes, around my nose, and T-zone. Do not touch your cheekbones with translucent powder, because all you work with all your lotions are just gonna be done. So just do your T-zone and under your eyes and you're good. Man, these allergies. Alright, so the next step is, let's do the tiniest bit of contouring. So I'm gonna go into that shade right there, and I'm going to use this type of brush. So if all you have is powder contour and you don't have a brush that's this dense, use your finger and just blend it as much as you can with your finger. And if it doesn't blend so well, just grab a different brush that you might have that's a little bit dense and blend it out. So I don't know what I could use as an example, but if you have something, go ahead and ask me and I'll tell you if it works or not. Or just try it, just do it. Again, it's just makeup and you can take it off and you have time to play around and practice as much as you want. I think that the most important thing always when you apply makeup is blending. Blending with a brush, blending with your fingers. As long as you blend and you persist and you keep trying, trust me, it's gonna blend out. Just applying a little bit more contour, the cream kind. You really don't need to do this, but I'm just being extra because whatever, you know. Let's highlight. So I'm still gonna be working with my same palette. If you don't have a cream highlighter, use your regular highlighter. If you're doing it with your finger, tap very lightly. You see where your face catches the light? That's where you need to apply your highlighter. I'm talking about myself in the second person. But I'm talking to you, so you know what I mean. So I'm gonna highlight here where my forehead catches the light. I think we're good with highlighting for now. I've been going a little bit nuts seeing that you can still see the darkness under my eyes, which is fine because it's supposed to be a natural, no makeup makeup look, but I still want to get rid of it a little bit more. I don't know if you can tell the slight difference. So I grabbed my Kryon Professional Makeup Dual Finish pressed powder. So if you have any kind of pressed powder, maybe you can use that. And I went into the lightest shade with this brush, which I usually use on my lid, and I just applied it. Anywho, just apply it in the areas where you want to have a matte look, and I'm just gonna apply it here because I wear glasses, and that always the makeup on my nose always gets messed up because of my glasses. So yes, let's move on to blush. Be right back. I'm gonna make an assumption, and that is most people don't have cream blush, so I don't know. So a trick that you can do is to use your lipstick as a blush. So I grabbed this color. This is the L'Oreal Paris Le Matte in the shade, I have no idea. It's a velvety full coverage lip color. I don't know what shade this is, but anyway, I'm going to put it on the back of my hand, first of all, to warm it up. And I'm gonna grab from there with my finger, and I'm going to sandwich it between my highlighter and my contour. Right, so grabbing some more on my finger, applying it on the other side. If your lipstick has a lot of pigment, just grab from here and then do this, and then transfer it on to your face. Again, it takes practice to get to know your product, and it's makeup, and you can take it off. And I apply it on the rest of my face to bring that undertone and make the look more cohesive. So just different areas. I don't want to apply any eyeshadow on my eyes today. I just want the look to be focused on the skin. So I'm going to use my trusty translucent powder and set my eyes. I really didn't even need to put primer on, but that's fine. And the reason why I'm setting them with translucent powder is in case I didn't apply primer on before, I won't get any creasing from any creams or lotions or any other product that you've applied to your face and it's transferred onto your lid and you haven't even noticed. I feel like I need to sneeze. And also, it might just make your look more cohesive. You can, of course, stay like this and not add anything else. But I do want to add mascara, and I want to change things up a little bit. So I'm going to apply the Wonder Extensions Lash Extension Stain Mascara. I honestly thought this mascara was a lot better than it is. And to me, it's fine. It's great for a natural look. I mean, it's great. It's better than many others I've tried. But it's also very natural looking. Although that's not a bad thing. I like mascaras that make my lashes look very dramatic. And if you get any mascara on your lid, don't worry. Just let the mascara dry for several minutes and then get a clean spoolie brush and scrape it off, and it's gonna be off. And apply to your bottom lashes too. Time for lipstick. Use whatever color you want. You can use a dramatic shade because it's not going to compete with your eyes. But if you want the makeup look, then use a softer shade. And if you want, you can grab a fluffy brush and soften the edges. Again, that's gonna make it look more natural. You can clean it on the back of your hand. So sharper edges, it's gonna be 100% evident that you have lipstick on. But to soften the edges, who knows? Maybe you do, maybe you don't. Or maybe it looks like you were kissing someone. All right. You can also just put a little bit more, but in the inner center. Right, so that's my look for you guys today. Don't forget setting spray. This smells so good. This is the I Love Revolution Fixing Spray, Peaches and Cream, and it really smells like peaches and cream. It's so fresh, such a delicious scent. I really recommend it. So yeah, that's the look for today, the no makeup look. I hope that you guys liked it, that you learned something, and I don't know, that you're able to recreate it. So let me know if you like it, and if you have any questions, tell me. I would love your opinion on this look and the technique I showed you. So if you could please write in the comments or send me a private message or just let me know, sending me a video, that would be really cool. I'd love to receive a video from you telling me what you think of the look, of the technique. Did you recreate it? Is it easy? Is it hard? Are you gonna try it? Are you not? Are you gonna use it when we're able to go out of the house? Or maybe do it inside your house so your partner can be like, ooh, you look super cute. You look extra cute for me inside the house. I'm just being silly. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. All right, bye.